And welcome to Picking Up the Needles. I am Kim. In this video, I am going to talk about what I have finished, what I have on my needles, and my plans for fall. Hi, I am Kim. I'm coming to you from the Netherlands. I live in Overijssel in Hengelo. That's a little town surrounded by lots of countryside sites. Very pretty area to live in, to bike in, to walk in. Yeah, it's very pretty, I think. It's my opinion. Yeah, let's begin with what I have on myself. It's the strawberry summer top. I have finished it. Yay! And I'll show you a video of me wearing it, but yeah, it's not doable in this studio, so that's why I'm going to another place to show you. But I can tell you something about it. It took me a little bit more time than I have expected. It was thin yarn, and I thought, well, I can knit it in a week, but I didn't. I needed 3 weeks to finish it, so yeah, but I finished it. It's a very airy top, and I can wear it today because it's a very nice weather in the Netherlands. It was very rainy and not very warm, and now finally the sun came in, and we have a week full of sunshine, and I hope sunshine and a lot of fun things to do, I think. Well, let's talk about the summer strawberry summer top. Yeah, I knit it not in the saffron. This is saffron, but another color. Because I didn't want another top in a dark blue. Because I have knitted a soda fountain in this. This yarn, and yeah, I wanted another color, and I was curious about the Hobie Friends 8/8/4. So yeah, I love it. I really love the yarn, the cotton, the feel of it. It's not that stiff. It's a little bit flowy, and yeah, I'm really it knit up very easily. I needed 3 weeks to complete this this project, and when I before I started the front and the back, because you are knit it top down, from bottom up. It was very I get bored of it a bit, I think, because it was constantly the same stitch, a rib stitch of 2x2, and I really wanted to do something else. So so I was very glad when I can put on the top and the back in it, because you then have to knit something else. But meanwhile, I have cast on another project because of I was bored of it. I cast it on the bandanas, but I don't have it with me because I didn't work on it a couple of last 2 weeks because I wanted to make this, finish this. That was the reason. It was not this project what I thought was in between. But I finished it and I'm very happy. It's a very airy and a very nice top to wear. I could make it a little bit longer. But I think when I didn't block it any yet. I thought I have to wear it, so put it on. I didn't block it, but I think when I block it, I would. It's cotton, so it will grow. I think I know. So I think I'm okay. Because I did it not in the saffron, but in the hobby 8/4. I think the gauge was a little bit different, but I didn't have any problems with it. Except I think this could be a little bit bigger, but yeah, I don't mind. I don't care. But if but I didn't have any problems with sizing and recalculating all things. No, I didn't. I just knit it as is. So that brings me to my next, because I have finished this. I would finish my sweater for my sister-in-law. It isn't finished, but I'm coming quite a long way. I didn't put a progress marker on it. I should have done that. But okay. Well, this is it. This is the front. It's because of this marker. The other markers are these. And I'm close to separating the sleeves from the body. So I think I'm going to make it. I think it's going to finish by fall. So my sister-in-law, she's actually her birthday is in fall. So maybe I can give it to her as a present. That would be nice. If I can do that. But okay. I'm there is progress in this project. I made it in Drop Sky. I really love the Drop Sky. It's very soft, it's very airy and light, and yeah, just love it. So yeah, I want to make myself a sweater like that. So, but because I've get bored, I sometimes get bored about doing one thing. Since what is that? I'm only knitting stockinette stitch, and sometimes increasing. Then I get bored about it, so I cast on another project. It's a new project. It's the dumpling bag by Pearl Soho. This one, because I'm going to knit another one because more of it for my projects. I think it's a very cute project bag. This one I made like the as the pattern says, with a professional cast on, but I'm not happy with that. Because this would sewn, this should be sewn together with the Kitchener stitch. And I'm not very good at the Kitchener stitch. So the next bag I'm going to make is going to be with the Turkish cast on. Then you don't have to knit the Kitchener stitch. I also do that with my socks, because I really, really like the Turkish cast on. It's a very quick and easy cast on, and yeah, so that's it. I'm making this in Hobie Rainbow 8/8 ply, so that's the thickest of the 100% cotton yarn. I hoped I could make it in one color, but I can't. I had ordered a bag with different colors in it, also one skein of different. Every color was different, of every skein was a different color. And so I hope I only need two skeins of this yarn. One bag, but yeah, well, it's gonna be project bag, it's gonna be more of them, and I'm going to line it with fabric because then it cannot stretch out much, I hope. And yeah, that's going to be my project bags, and I think when I finish them, I'm going to hang them on the door with a harmonica coat rack, where I can put this and all my projects. So we have a nicer background, I hope. But that's in the future. So that was project number 2, 500 needles. And then I have a sock on the needles. My socks are also having the Turkish cast on, because you cannot see that I did it. So, and a shadow repeal, because I was struggling with the heels. If you see my previous videos, I was, you can see I was struggling with the heel, and I found the shadow wrap heel, and I really liked it. It is a nice heel. I don't make it as neat as I want to, but we need to practice. This is the shadow wrap heel. And yeah, that's the way I make my socks, basically. And it's from Toe Up, because I liked it, because I like Toe Up. So I don't have to make the Kitchener stitch. I do everything to avoid that. And this is self-striping yarn, so I know when I'm going to be here. I think I'm almost there. Then I can go on and... No, I am almost there. But then I can go on to make the rib border and end with a... one of the blue stripes, but I think I am already there, but I don't like the height, so maybe I need to go another round with it, but then it would be too high, I think. Well, I don't know, it's a Spontaneous. Nee, not spontaneous. It doesn't have a pattern or something like that. So maybe I'm going to knit until I'm done and see. And the next sock will or won't be the same. Well, it would be the same yarn, but not the same color stripes. Well, I don't care. Because these socks are for myself. So, yeah, I think I don't mind. I think I'm going further than the one stripe. So, that's that. Then we are going to my fall knittings, plans, and stuff. Yeah, first of all, I have something on my needles, but I'm going to rip it out because it was not very neat. And I don't know where I saw it. There were some mistakes in it. Now I can't find it anymore. No, not here. Yeah, here. If you can see it, I don't know. But I basically screwed up the square. It should be nice and neat. And it isn't in here. So I think I'm going to frog this. And then I think I'm not going to make it in round. Because my husband wants a long scarf he can put over his head. And I think this is not long enough. So I think I'm going to make it in this size instead of this. If I'm making any sense. I think I'm going to make it a long rectangle and then put it together. So this is going to be ripped again. I don't know. I think I've ripped it out this project at least 3 times already for the same reason. I somehow screw up. It's going to be very nice, and then at the end I'm screwing things up. I mess it up and then it's going to be crooked. So yeah, this is going to be ripped out. And then I have 2 other projects I want to make this fall. And that's, I'm going to, that's a cabled trui. We call a sweater in Netherlands. It's called a trui. So that was my mispronunciation. Don't care. I'm going to make the honeycomb iron. It's cabled and I really want to make a cabled sweater. I never done it before, so I think I can do it. It's a quote of Pippi Langkous. I don't know if you Pippi Langstrumpf, that is Deutsch. I put a picture of her in my so you know who I am, who I'm talking about. Yeah, that's the honeycomb Erin, and I'm going to make it in Drops Charisma. I've ordered it a long time ago, and I always wanted to make a cabled sweater. Really want to challenge myself to do that. And so I've ordered Drops Charisma. I dropped a lot of it, and then it became a spring, and I didn't start the project yet. I thought, well, no, I'm going to make it for the winter fall. So that's why it's in my stash, but it was for another sweater. But I really like this sweater better. This sweater better. It rhymes. So that's why I'm going to make the honeycomb errand in the Drops Charisma. It's a B category. I think it must be a DK weight or an errand weight. I think it's an errand weight. And yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I have a lot of this, too much, so maybe I can make another sweater for my daughter, but I don't think she wants that, because she don't want the same clothes as I have, understandably, because she is a teenager and teenagers don't want that. And then I have another project. It's I think it's a very old project because there is no name for it, just numbers. It is a drops project. It's 75/15. I put the links down below so you can look it up. And it's a kind of pullover. It's very long, to below the knees. And I like to wear leggings because I don't like the feel of jeans. But I do like leggings a lot. So that's why I thought, well, if I'm going to make a long kind of sweater, then I can put my legging on it. Because if you are wearing leggings and you have a short sweater on it, no, makes me very self-conscious. So that's why I chose this one, and it has pockets because I like it. I like pockets. So yeah, that's what I'm going to make this fall. And I don't have anything else to say. No, that's all I have to say. So I wanna thank you for watching this video, and have a nice knitting week, and I see you next week. Bye bye.